What are you doing with your weapon?
Getting the fingerprints off my old Markov. There. Now only his fingerprints are on it.
I see your plan now.
When the police come to investigate my telephone call, they will find Yahshua dead. And this man with the murder weapon. If fortune is with us, they will arrest her criminal friends at the same time.
These police will be distracted. Then nothing will stand between us and victory.
Quick, Ossup. Get back into my satchel. We should leave before we are discovered.
Look, Sergeant. Two bodies.
Get the woman.
What? She's dead. Gunshot.
This one's alive. And the gun is horrible.
Gun? How did I get a hold of that?
Let's take him to the car.
Oh, thanks, guys. No, it's okay. I can still walk. Hey, hold it. What in wrestling on Scarlet Talks is going on?
You are under arrest.
Say what?
I said you are under...
I know that. What's the charge, anyway?
The murder of Helena Yahshua. Conspiring to...
No, wait. It wasn't me.
Come along.
Stop that. Just a minute. Listen. Oh, two stripes. Corporal, listen. It wasn't me.
Mark, what's going on? Do you see anything?
Not much. All those trees in the way, it's hard to see the whole operation. Wait.
What? What is it?
Wait, Derek, give Mark a moment.
Some of Krasovic's people are coming back to the road. There. They have five more people in custody.
Yes.
Ah, more good news. So far, this little field excursion is going much better than the last one. And no one has fired a shot.
This was almost too easy.
And why would you say that, eh, Commander?
Come on, Doctor. All those Russians weren't even ready for an attack. Definitely not an aerial assault like this one. They were just hiding out there in the forest surrounding the missile silo.
As if they expected an attack only on the ground.
Right. They were completely unprepared for this.
Then, what were they expecting?
Sergeant Krasovic, can you hear me?
Please, Colonel Crichton. I can see you. The area is secure for landing.
There he is. We've got you in sight. We're coming down to meet you.
Standing by.
Sergeant Krasovic had better be right about the area being secure. This is it. Let him in. He's in. Go, go.
What's wrong?
As far as I know, the leader hasn't been caught yet, and he's probably very dangerous. The doctor says his name is Ossup.
We have not found him yet. But we did find the smuggler's body in the forest, and a foreigner beside her with a murder weapon. A man in a long dark trench coat, a dark suit and a hat, and a rose pinned to his coat.
Odd. Just a moment. Did you say body?
I did. Yahshua was shot dead.
Probably knew too much.
Possible. Corporal Bishop is taking the foreigner back to Yekaterinburg for questioning, along with the rest of the criminals.
Good. Now the nuclear missiles are safe. But I get the feeling there's more ahead of us.
What about this Ossup you mentioned?
He, or it, is why I have that feeling.
Oh, I can't get used to this pace. A quick meal on one side of the planet, stop one nuclear holocaust, and you're whisked away over here to Russia, and lots of hurry up and wait in between.
Then hurry up and rest. We might not get another chance to recoup before we move out again.
Swell.
Madeira, haven't you ever wanted to see the world? And with the TARDIS, not even a touch of jet lag.
That's true, I guess. Still, it's starting to feel like Mission Impossible.
I thought you said it was James Bond. I
haven't made up my mind yet.
Colonel Crichton, busy as usual?
Yes, I've been on the phone with Unit HQ in Geneva. I reported our status here where they brought me up to date on their situation.
So what's going on?
Unit has advised every nation to initiate a nuclear fail-safe procedures. Beyond that, there isn't much to pass on.
That's all?
Miss Hamilton, do bear in mind that Unit is a secret organization. At any rate, my aide is still on the line. We'll get any new information as it comes in.
Doctor? You are here, aren't you?
What is it, Doctor?
Doctor, are you all right?
What's wrong?
Had a bit of a start, that's all. I think someone is asking for me.
Push it to Crichton.
Crichton here.
The man we arrested earlier this afternoon.
Has he escaped?
Perfect.
No, sir. He's still in the holding cell. but he keeps demanding to see the doctor.
But he wasn't hurt when you brought him in, was he?
No, sir, not a doctor. The doctor.
The doctor? But how did he know he was here?
Move over. We are not in the bus.
No, I'm trying. Whatever is in this satchel must obey.
This is me, Ossup.
Sorry, Ossup.
The contract doesn't have much room, but it's all I could get. Everyone, patient. The missile silo is only a few hours away.
Hours?
Enough! What are the things we asked for?
Here, in this cloth sack. But we couldn't borrow from our own homes. We stole.
They're gone.
What are we going to do with all these things? They're only good for cooking or cleaning.
Not so. They also make explosives.
We are going to throw bombs at Russian soldiers?
They need not be lethal, Ivashov.
Whatever we do, we will be outnumbered and outgunned. We have to keep the guards busy somehow.
While the rest of you build your weapons, I will attempt to build a primitive deflector shield device from what I could salvage from my ship. It will last only a short time. Then I can bring into the fray my own weapons.
Everyone, right this way.
Thank you. Dad, Mark, come along.
You can see the prisoner through this two-way mirror.
That's him? Looks like someone in a hologram black and white movie.
I don't know. That tie looks more like the 60s.
Yes, rather loud, isn't it?
Doctor, are you sure you want to meet this man?
Colonel Crichton is right. That man is a security risk. Possibly a murderer.
Maybe I should go in with you.
Gentlemen, I appreciate your suggestions, believe me. But I insist. Please shut off all monitoring devices. That mirror thingy as well. I must speak to him in private.
Oh, but Doctor!
Alone. Please.
All right. I'll meet you there with the key.
Thank you. This shouldn't take too long. Feel free to start dinner without me, but if someone could reserve a little something for me, I would be ever so grateful. Now, if you'll excuse me.
This doesn't feel right.
I agree. But he can't be a spy. He's too obvious.
One of your men might have seen or heard something near the missile silo this afternoon. Something that could validate our suspicions about this man.
Hey, can anybody hear me? Come on! Could you at least give me back all my comic books?
Good evening. Are you all right in here?
Who are you?
Don't you recognize me? I'm the one you've been trying to contact.
Doctor? Where's your scarf?
Made me itch. Don't worry. We can speak freely. Now, why did you bring me and my companions into this crisis? To amuse the Time Lords?
But they didn't send me here.
They didn't? What are you doing here?
On the run, like yourself. I got sick of the Time Lords and their incompetence. The disasters on Gallifrey recently, as well as this one.
But the Time Lords do know what's happening here.
Yes, for at least a century. I was looking for data on Earth's Tunguska event to complete the historical records in the Panopticon. When I realized that the Niseus had made first contact with the humans, I petitioned the High Council to study this further.
That means the Time Lords could have stopped this madness before it started. Fools.
Exactly. But they refused to intervene. So, I stole a TARDIS and came here to study this world and prepare for the alien's next appearance. I've discovered new concepts here. One fascinates me the most. Justice.
But why lure me and my friends here?
I can't handle this alone. By the time I realized that the aliens were already here, the damage was done. So I sent a distress signal and hoped you might find it before someone else did. You're the only Time Lord I can trust.
Oh dear, this is a fine mess. What's your name?
Well, it's, Gaspilorik Essex.
Really?
But I've borrowed an Earth name. Harlan.
Ah, much better. Perhaps we can help each other after all. But one condition. Refrain from using your Time Lord abilities as much as possible. There's such a thing as an abuse of power.
I don't understand.
If you won't consider that, at least consider how much Artron energy you're using. Exhaust yourself.
But those murderers have incurred the wrath of the Time Lords. They must see the wrath and be punished.
But there is more to justice than punishment. And what about that old man you sent here?
Maxim Grigorovich.
Yes. You terrified that man. That was an abuse of such power. Human beings can be very obliging, but only if treated with due respect. I'm sorry, young man, but I cannot help you if this continues.
Okay, okay. I expected a greedy bureaucrat. Instead, I bullied an old man who didn't mean any harm. Obviously, I have much more to learn.
Still, your heart's in the right places, I suppose. Now it's time for us Tyanlos to put our heads together. Ossup and his cohorts have revived the dark dreams of nuclear war and conquest. If we don't stop them, millions of people will die.
So, Doctor, aren't you going to introduce us?
Ah, yes, my manners. Now, Harlan, this is Commander Mark Triad, Starfleet.
Starfleet? I could get some first-hand historical knowledge about Earth from you, and the Xylon War.
Unless it's classified.
And this is Miss Dara Hamilton.
Hi, nice rouge you have there.
This is my lapel. I'd be polite and offer it to you, but it's a little battered. O Rose, thou art sick. The invisible worm that flies in the night, and the howling storm has found thy bed of crimson joy, and his dark secret love does thy life destroy.
Wow. What was that from?
An English poet. David Blake.
Really? I thought it was...
Just humor him.
Well, keeping our newcomer occupied, Doctor? Occupied? Makes me sound like a restroom.
Now, Colonel Crichton is expressing his interest. There, he's brought your things.
Standard procedure to look for concealed items and such. Well, they look all right, but it's a good thing I got them back. This issue of Dream Corridor won't be out for another year.
Dream Corridor? I've always wanted that. Where did you get it?
Doctor, are you sure we can trust this person? Look what happened the last time we had to deal with the Time Lords.
Yeah, he's nice and all, but something doesn't seem right. If he's a Time Lord, shouldn't he sound British like the others?
He would if he spent more time in Great Britain, Dara. It's more subjective than you think. And Mark, yes, we can trust him. But a wary eye would not be uncalled for, if you catch my meaning. That folder looks interesting, Sergeant Krasovic. What do you have there?
Notes I made when I was conducting a few interviews.
So what have you found?
Nothing that confirms our suspicion about this man.
I realize that comic books aren't for everyone, but did you have to lock me up?
You are still a murder suspect.
But you said you found nothing.
I questioned the men on guard at the missile silo who told me they saw a man and a woman walking in the forest. The man does not match his description.
Of course not. He was at least several centuries older than me.
You mean decades, don't you?
Yeah, that too. Anyway, the woman called him by name. Murdzin. He shot her.
Oh, no.
What is it now?
Don't you see? Murdzin must be working with Ossup. We captured the wrong people and gave them time to act. Ossup must be making his move now.
The guards are out cold. The gas works.
Good, good. Tell the other two humans to return quickly. This metal door will be cut free at any moment.
Evershaw, Teaser, come quickly. We must guide the door to the ground. Ossup's work is almost done.
Right, I'm ready.
Finished!
What does that sound?
Airships! I see them in the moonlight!
We're trapped!
No! We fooled them! I know it!
Enough! Use those makeshift gas grenades once more! Prepare to face the enemy!
But what can we do?
We can war! Above all, war!
Strike forces in position, Colonel!
All right, men. Protect the Doctor and his companions at all times, right?
Yes, sir.
Night vision goggles activated?
Quite so, Colonel. Everything's dark.
Like that.
Ah, much better. Thank you, Mark.
Right, let's move out!
They're throwing tin cans at us!
Talk about low budget.
I say, one of them has sprung a leak.
Gas! Everyone down! Gas attack!
Hold your position! Our enemy will fall back! We'll circle around!
Over here, Harlan! I have a plan! Come with me!
Now, Doctor!
What are they doing?
The Doctor must be trying to smother the gas canisters with his body!
They both are!
They're mad! Sergeant, get the helicopters over here! Let's see if we can kick up enough air to get rid of that cloud!
I'm on it, sir! Too late! They're both down!
The gas! It's blowing away! It's working!
Then let's go! Everyone move!
Doctor, can you hear me? Harlan?
Commander Triad?
I'm still looking for a pulse. Come on.
What? I'm chopped liver over here?
Huh? Come now, they're only human.
Doctor!
That was a foolish risk!
What did you do?
I thought you were both dead.
We're only thinking of y'all, my dear Charles. Our Time Lord physiology allows us to close the breathing passages. For a short while, anyway. Did we miss anything?
Commander Triad, Miss Hamilton, help them up. Ossup and his friends must be inside by now. Come on!
Hands in the air!
I am not defeated yet.
Get the gas grenades!
Stand by!
Giza, get their rifles. Go!
What is that?
My deflector shield generator. Or do you doubt me still?
I certainly don't trust you. You enjoy this far too much.
A wise observation.
Stop this bickering. Our task is difficult enough.
Meriton, careful how you carry me.
Their rifles.
Good. You and Evershoff, take one each and stand watch here. Ossup and I are going to the missile launching devices.
I'm frightened, Evershoff.
We'll manage, but no more jokes.
Fan out!
If you can, in this place.
All these corridors join and lead to the control stations, shelters, and storage rooms. But the launching systems are disconnected. No power to them.
I'm sure Ossup has a contingency plan for that very problem, Sergeant Krasovic.
Everyone wait. I smell hints of that gas.
Yes, but it dissipates quickly.
Sir, there are two armed civilians several meters ahead.
Keep them in your sights, but fire only on command. Position yourselves around Sergeant Krasovic so the rest of us are in the middle. And let's keep the casualties on both sides at a minimum, right?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, stop here!
Who is there?
Sergeant Krasovic! KGB!
Stay there! Or
we
shoot!
I could age their organs from here.
No! Give them a chance to surrender.
If you put your guns down, I'm sure we can help you. We're quite obliging, actually.
I told you!
No!
Now!
She's gone into shock. Help her!
Good. I only got her arm. Field kit, Sergeant.
Right here, sir. Ossup and Mertzen must have left them here to buy enough time until they reach the missile controls.
Probably. But at least we've lost only precious time, instead of precious lives.
Ossup and Mertzen would see to that, Doctor, if they reach the controls before we do.
Guards!
Stay where you are! Not have reached for their guns.
Of course not, moronic peasants. Move these carcasses to one side and clear the path to the launching systems. My work begins.
Doctor, look!
Pre-launch countdown!
Where there's life, there's hope. Come on!
Let me give you a hand. Are you all right?
I just got a bloody check with some energy for you. What do you think?
Hey, in there! That's Mertzen!
Do you have a sonic screwdriver?
The only safe way to knock down that barrier?
Top of the class, my boy, and we must find a weakness in the fence.
What is that at the launch controls?
Awesome. He's using power from his own environment suit to keep the launch systems online.
Amazing.
The waste is incredible, perhaps, humans. But your world dies for a greater cause.
Thanks for nothing.
The shield's down! Go!
Everyone listen! There's a better way!
What do you want ever listen?
The controls!
No! I won't let you! This is too important!
I've got him! Somebody get his feet!
Got it! Good job!
This thing still has power!
We only have a few seconds left, my boy!
5 seconds!
No!
3, 2, 1! No! We won! We won! A new Soviet Union!
Shut up, Earther!
Mertzen! The man is catatonic!
What have you done?
I don't know. I wasn't trying.
It can't end like this!
No, there's still a chance. If Harlan's mind can reach the telepathic circuits of my TARDIS, I have a transmat system on board. But the risk...
I'll take it. Is it possible?
He's already proved he can, Colonel Crichton. But the necessary amount of Archon energy is tremendous.
Gotcha! He can't do it, Doctor.
But we can. My mind and his.
Another trip around the world.
For the world.
Concentrate. We can do it.
Let this...
Here we go. Mark, come with me.
Doctor, what about Harlan?
Dear, dear. Keep him here. Look after him. Mark, watch the trajectory of those missiles.
What are you doing?
I can snatch them away from the Earth with a tractor beam, capture them with the TARDIS's defense screens, then fling them away from the elliptical plane of the solar system. Not even an asteroid would be harmed.
We'll have to be above the North Pole to do it.
Naturally. Is the door locked?
You want Miss Hamilton out of the room for a reason.
The explosions from those nuclear warheads might impair dematerialization. If we fail, I can eject the entire transmat room down to Earth. At least they'll be safe.
Good. We're far over the northern ice cap. The missiles aren't quite ready to descend back into Earth's atmosphere.
Well, if they aren't ready... There, no need to force them. They're on their way toward us. Oh dear.
That didn't sound reassuring.
Too much interference between the shields and the tractor beam, I'm afraid. Now the system is overloaded. I can't shut it off. A slight flaw in my plan.
Slight? That indicator says it all. Only microns to impact. We're on a collision course.
No need to shout. I get flustered when people shout at me.
Do something.
I'm thinking. Ah, yes, that's it. Dematerialize on my mark. Remember, not 1 second earlier, those missiles will be flung back toward Earth.
Or 1 second late, or we'll be turned into space dust.
Ever the optimist.
8, 7, brace for impact!
Overruled!
We did it. We did it.
Yes, we did, old girl.
Thank you for your cooperation, Sergeant Krasovic.
I should be thanking you, Colonel. My government couldn't have responded to the crisis without you.
If it wouldn't be too forward, I'd say UNIT and the KGB work well together.
Indeed, Sergeant. A good start for UNIT Russia.
I agree. But perhaps you could explain how the Doctor and others disappeared from inside Silo.
Par for the course, for members of UNIT, that is.
And then the Doctor comes up with something new.
Corporal Bishop, never has a more true word been said.
Oh, fine. Really.
Are you certain? Can you navigate your TARDIS on your own?
Yes, I'm still feeling fatigue, but a week or two out of my permanent vacation should do it. Either way, more time for me to wrap my mind around all these issues couched with injustice.
A dyed-in-the-wool Time Lord interested in justice.
As opposed to an eccentric renegade like me?
An eccentricity the Time Lord should have taught me.
Back up, Harlan. You want justice. A far greater stride than the ones our fellows would make. You'll go farther if you learn another human concept linked to justice. Compassion.
Maybe that's what William Blake meant in that other poem.
Which one?
All I remember is one line. Mercy has a human heart. If you don't mind, a battered rose.
Thank you.
He disappeared.
Who did?
Never mind, Charles. All aboard for England.
Better than the underground, this is.
Come along, Dara. Dara?
You're not about Harlan, are you?
Aren't I? I mean, he was kind of cute, in an intense sort of way.
Despite appearances, he is a Time Lord. And an older man. By about a few hundred years, if I recall.
Oh? Oh, well. After all, like you said, he is a Time Lord. Maybe now I have something to look backward to.
I think it's time to go.
Both eyes ahead, Dara.
Yeah, after you, Doctor.